students. So in previous Zoom class, we have revised few sums from chapter 1, right? So in this class, we are going to revise both the chapter 1 and chapter 2. Okay, so this is chapter 1. Okay, what is the formula of diameter? Diameter equal to 2 into radius. Diameter equal to 2 into radius. If we wanted to find out diameter, what we have to do is, we have to multiply the radius with 2. Okay, so diameter equal to 2 into radius. And if we wanted to find out the radius of a circle, what we have to do? We have to divide the diameter by 2. So if we wanted to find out the radius of a circle, we have to divide the diameter by 2. So the formula of radius is diameter divided by 2. So the diameter equal to 2 into radius, and radius equal to diameter divided by 2. So again I am repeating, if we wanted to find out diameter, we have to multiply radius into 2, that is 2 into radius. And if we wanted to find out radius of a circle, we have to divide the diameter by 2. So this sums we discussed in Zoom class. So now I am revising this. So the first sum, what is the question? The radius of a circle is 5 cm. Find the diameter. So we have given the radius as 5 cm. We are going to find out the diameter. Okay. So what is the formula of diameter? We are going to find out the diameter. So we have to write the formula of diameter. So what is the formula of diameter? Diameter equal to 2 into radius. Diameter equal to 2 into radius. So write the formula first. Diameter equal to 2 into radius. So 2, what is the radius given in the question? 5 cm. So 2 into 5 cm, 5 2s are 10 cm. Now we have found diameter as 10 cm. Okay. So next question. The diameter of a circle is 88 cm. Find the radius. So in this question, they have given diameter as 88 cm. And we are going to find out the radius. Okay, so what is the formula of radius? Radius equal to diameter divided by 2. Radius equal to diameter divided by 2. So in the question, we have diameter as 88 cm. So substitute diameter as 88 cm divided by 2. So what is 88 by 2? So if we divide 88 by 2, we will get 44. So radius equal to 44 cm. So we found radius as 44 cm. And next we discussed about perimeter. So what is perimeter? Sum of all closed figure is known as perimeter. So we have, what is the meaning of sum? Sum means add. Sum means add. Okay. So we are going to add this sum. So they have given this diagram. What is this? This is parallelogram. So they have given A, B, C and D. These are the sides. So four sides are there. They have given A, B as 8 cm, B, C as 3 cm, C, D as 5 cm and D, A as 6 cm. We are going to find out the perimeter now. So, what is perimeter? Sum of all the sides. So, perimeter equal to AB. AB is one side, BC is another side, CD is another side and DA is another side, right? So, perimeter equal to AB plus BC plus CD plus DA. Okay. AB plus BC plus CD plus DA. So what is AB is 8. And what is BC? BC is 3 cm. And CD is 5 cm. Then DA is 6 cm. We substitute that and we are going to add now. So what is 8 plus 3? 8 plus 3 is 11. And what is 5 plus 6? 5 plus 6 is 11. So if we add 11 plus 11, we will get 22. So perimeter of this sum is 22 cm. Okay. Next, second sum. So what is this? This is square. So in square, all the sides are equal. In square, all the sides are equal. So in question, they have given only the side of PQ. The measurement of PQ. PQ is 11 cm. We don't know this QR. We don't know SR. We don't know SP. So in square, all the sides are equal. So if PQ is 11 cm, what about SR? SR is also 11 cm. Okay. All sides are equal in square. So SP and QR also equal. Okay. So we are going to find out the perimeter. So perimeter equal to PQ plus QR plus RS plus SP. Okay. Substitute all the values. 11 plus 11 plus 11 plus 11. So what is 11 plus 11? 22. Here what is 11 plus 11? 22. So if we add 22 plus 22, the answer is 44 cm. So the perimeter of a square, given square is 44 cm. And we have also revised this one. Find the perimeter of a rectangle whose sides are 12 cm and 8 cm. Okay, this is a question. Find the perimeter of a rectangle whose sides are 12 cm and 8 cm. Okay, so this is a rectangle, right? So they have given 12 cm and 8 cm. First, we are going to name the sides A, B, C and D. Okay, 4 sides. So we are giving AB as 12 cm and BC as 8 cm. So in rectangle, opposite sides are equal. In rectangle, opposite sides are equal. AB is equal to DC. Okay. AB is equal to DC and AD is equal to BC. So, we already wrote AB as 12 cm and BC as 8 cm. So, if AB is 12 cm, then DC is also 12 cm because opposite sides are equal. Right? AB is opposite to DC. And if BC is 8 cm, AD is also 8 cm because opposite sides are equal in rectangle. BC is opposite to AD. Okay, now we got all the measurement. So we are going to do perimeter of a rectangle. So perimeter of a rectangle equal to AB plus BC plus CD plus DA. We are going to add all the sides. So what is AB? AB is 12 cm. What is BC? BC is 8 cm. And what is CD? CD is 12 cm. And what is DA? DA is 8 cm. So if we add all this, 12 plus 8, 20. And what is 12 plus 8? 20. And 20 plus 20 is 40 cm. So the perimeter of a given rectangle is 40 cm. So page number 20. A. Write the following number in words. Write the following number in words. Okay. So they've given 1006, 6327. Third one, 9097. Fourth one, 10,000. And fifth one, 8906. So shall we write the number names of this?
Yes.
So what is the first one? 1006. So write 1006. So here ones, tens, hundreds, thousand. So what is this? 6327. Write this. 6327. Okay, next third one. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. Okay, so what is this? 9000. No hundred. So 9097. Right? 9097. Okay, the next one. 10,000. Can easily write this. 10,000. Next fifth one. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. 8,900. No tens. So, and six. So, write 8,900. Zero is there. So, put and six. Okay. Easy one. So, you revise all this. Next B. Write the numerals. Write the numerals. What is the first one? 7. 7,000. And 64. So what is 7,000? 7,000. And 64. So no hundreds. So put 0, 64. Okay. Second one. 4,000. 300. And 6. 4,306. No tens is there. So put 0, 6. Okay. Okay. Next. C. Answer the following question. In C, we are doing the second sum. Find the sum of the greatest 2-digit number. Greatest 2-digit number. So what is greatest 2-digit number? 99. And the greatest 3-digit number. Greatest 3-digit number. What is greatest 3-digit number? 999. So they are given find the sum. So if sum means you have to add. So shall we add 999 plus 99? So what is 9 plus 9? 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So 18. 8 here and 1 in nearby place. So what is 1 plus 9? 10. 10 plus 9? 19. So 9 here and 1 here. So the answer is 1098. So if we write this in number names, 1000, no 100 is there. So put and 98. Okay, next is odd number and even number. Very easy one. So if you wanted to find out odd number and even number, you just take the ones place. So the numbers ending with 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9 in ones place, those numbers are odd numbers. Okay. So the numbers ending with 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9 in ones place, those numbers are odd number. An even number, the number ending with 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8 in ones place, those numbers are known as even numbers. Okay, so this is even numbers and this is odd numbers. 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9 comes under odd number, whereas 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 comes under even number. Okay. So 3217, is it odd number or even number? So in ones place we have 7. So 7 means odd number. Okay. 3946. So which is ones place? 6 is in ones place. So 6 comes under even number. Okay. Next. 2121. So in ones place we have 1. So 1 comes under odd number. Next. 1234. So we have 4 in ones place. So it comes under what? Even number. So you just remember 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9 comes under odd number, whereas 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 comes under even number. Okay, next is place value and face value. Okay, so the place value, if you wanted to find the place value, for example, if we have 2745, so the place value of 5 is, it is in ones place, right? So 5 into 1 equal to 5. Okay, so the place value of 5 is 5, and the place value of 4 it is in tens place, so 4 into 10, what is the answer? 40. So the place value of 4 is 40. And 7, so 7 it's in hundreds place. So 7 into 100, 700. The place value of 7 is 700. Then 2. 2 it's in the thousands place. So 2 into 1000, 2000. So the place value of 2 is 2000. Okay, this is the place value. So if we wanted to find the face value of 4, okay, if we wanted to find the face value of 4, so the face value is the same number itself. So the face value of 4 is 4. The face value of 5 is 5. The face value of 7 is 7. The face value of 2 is 2. So place value means it's in the which place. We have to find out the number, it's in which place. Whereas in face value, the number itself. Okay, we will get the number itself. Next, expanded form. Expanded form. Okay, we are going to expand 6785. Okay, so how we can expand? So, 6. How many numbers are there? 3 numbers are there. Oh, so put 3 zeros. 6000 plus 7. So how many numbers are there? 2 numbers are there. So put 20 plus next 8. 8. After 8 how many number? 1 number. So put 10. Then 5. So after 5 no numbers are there. So only 5. Okay. For example, 9999. Shall we expand this? So first thousands place 9. So after this thousands place, how many places are there? 3 places are there. So put 30 plus, then in hundreds place 9. After this we have 2 place, so put 20, then this 9. Tens place, so after this 10, then 9. Okay, very easy one. Okay, next, ascending order. And descending order. What is ascending order? Ascending order means small number to big number, that is large number. Descending order means big number to small number. Ascending order means small number to big number. Descending order means big number to small number. Okay, for example, 7,687, 7,687, 7,687, 34, 5,486, 8,918. So we are going to do this in ascending form. Okay, so ascending order. So which is the small number here? 7, 9, 7, 5, 8. 5 is the small number. So write 5,486. So after 5, which is the small number? 7 is the small number here. So here we have 2 sevens. So after 7 we have 6 here, here also 6. So after here 3, here also 3. Here 1 and here 4. So this comes in the second place. 7,631, and this comes in third place. 7,634. So after this, 8 is the small number. So 8,918, it comes in the fourth place, and this comes in the last place, 9,987. So if we write this as descending order, which is the largest number here? 9 is the largest number. So 9,987, then 8,918, then 7,634, then 7,631, and at last the smallest number, 5,436. So next, addition. You are going to do one sum from addition. 1,254 plus 1,424. Okay, so what is 4 plus 4? 4 after 5, 6, 7, 8. Right, 8. So what is 5 plus 2? 5 after 6, 7. What is 2 plus 4? 2 after 3, 4, 5, 6. And what is 3 plus 1? 4. Okay, easy one. You already know this. And we are going to put another sum from subtraction. Okay. 8,950. 6,750. Okay. We are going to subtract this. 1,000. Hundreds place, tens place, ones place. So if 0 and 0 means 0. 5 minus 5, 0. 9 minus 7, 9 minus 7 is 2. And what is 8 minus 6? 8 minus 6, 2. So the answer is 2,200. Okay, students, you revise all the sums. From exercise, from first lesson to the second lesson. Okay, so when is your max test? When is your max midterm test? 26th Wednesday. Okay, so you revise all the sums. So in the first chapter, you revise all the fill-ups and choose and all the number names, addition, subtraction, ascending order, descending order, what and all we revised. You just learn all this. Okay. So all the best for your first midterm test. Thank you, students.